It's hardcore brainwashing for children, hardcore. And this was perhaps their most flagrant case of brainwashing. Now we'll watch this together. I say we get through the whole thing. It's about 3 minutes, but I think it's important that we show the whole thing just because there's so much to it. Now, going into this, I'm only going to say this before we kind of commented on out of the back end and what I think from like concrete, does this violate the criminal code, down to the more kind of like, I don't know, philosophical, esoteric arguments. I am of the experience, the belief, the knowledge, the position, the view that children are not sexual. Right? Right? I understand that we have health class, kids are going through, you know, puberty at different ages, but the kids you're about to see right here don't exactly strike me, number one, at puberty level. So there's not really that whole sexuality to them whatsoever. And even when a kid reaches puberty, it does not necessarily mean that they should be sexually driven one way or another, right? That's why we have laws on the book about things like statutory rape. Now, when you get into drag queens and drag culture, this is something that is beyond a doubt sexual in nature, right? You'll see these kids refer to RuPaul time and time again. Now, RuPaul is a man who dresses not just as a woman, but as a, pardon my French, W-H-O-R-E, okay? I would not want my daughter dressing as RuPaul, let alone my son, okay? So let's just leave it there for a moment. And if there are any issues with audio whatsoever, please let me know and I'll pull up the comments here momentarily.
Oops. Okay. In regular times, her name is Bunny. But when she's in drag, whoopee! Madame. Bracken. I'm a 12-year-old hyper queen, meaning a 12-year-old female drag queen. My drag name is also my real name. Simple.
I'm Jason Kerr, and my drag name is Susan B. Anthony.
My name is Nemus. My drag name is Lactatia.
I'm Stefan, and my drag name is Lady Gaga.
Drag is a lot of things.
Drag is a performing art. Because you are the canvas.
Showing who you are, but like with singing and dancing.
Drag is just a self-expression and an art. You are the canvas. You do your own thing, and you perform.
A man transforms into a woman for entertainment, and a woman transforms into a man for entertainment.
I'm off the deep end, watch as I dive in. I'll never meet the ground.
I'm really liking No Excuses by Meghan Trainor.
Paparazzi.
Circus by Britney Spears.
Ginger Minj.
Alaska from season 5 and All Stars 2.
Ruby Diamond.
I like Baby Bell Bell.
Work spelt with an E or a U.
Fierce.
I like sachet.
Okay. Always have to end it with a tongue pop. I mean, it's like the period to the sentence.
That they can do drag too.
If anyone wants to bring you down, you fight back.
Not only that's okay, but that there are other people like that.
when you figure out you're gay or trans or something like that, it's not something that happens once you become an adult. It actually is around, like, all the kids of the documentary's age that we start kind of thinking about these things. And to just know that there are other kids that are here doing this, it shows that it's okay to do this and that you're not the only one. It's not weird.
I perform in front of crowds now and they cheer, so I know that I'm doing all right.
Drag has helped me express myself in a way that I'm not able to in everyday life. Walk my way down the road of self-discovery and figure out who I am as a person. And it's helped me connect with people in the community.
It's helped me to be myself.
Okay, so a lot to unpack there. A lot to unpack there. I don't have to point out to you, our astute high IQ audience, that there were children in rather compromising positions there, including in short shorts and like these belly shirts with their midriff showing, you know, doing these rainbow arches, etc., with their legs on the ground and high heels, etc. It begs the question as to whether or not this, as far as I'm concerned, is possibly a violation of our criminal code, specifically section 153.1b with respect to child sexual exploitation. But of course, people will say, but Faith, you're the one, by people I don't mean our high IQ audience, I mean the parents of these children who we'll get to in a moment, will say, you know, your mind's in the gutter. It's not these kids who see it sexually. Okay, but the Jeffrey Epsteins of the world will. And where are these kids performing? We know that 8-year-old drag queen, I can't remember his name, out of Montreal, I think it is, has been performing in adult bars. That Lactatia, his drag name, okay, with his like Antifa looking, I don't know, father and his morbidly obese mother, has also performed in adult venues, okay? So do those people not see it as sexual? Do they think it's just dress up? Entertainment for what purpose?
And what does that mean? Well, look, if you're a girl, right, from age 3 to 103, then if you're quietly nice to somebody and cute, you know, whatever, in some way, right, you're not really supposed to talk about it. You're not supposed to bring up the specifics. They may learn it. They may read magazines on it. They may practice in the mirror. It doesn't matter. You're not supposed to talk about it. Right? So that's girl world. And there's usually, you can be nice. They can also be quietly not nice, put out bad vibes, get back. Bad vibes, but they got better stuff because they're girls. They actually have something. 3, cute, 23, sexy, 53, classy, 83, sweet old lady, whatever, right? So that's girl world, right? And so girls can do it, and some guys that are gay or trans or whatever, that take it seriously, they can also do it to varying degrees. Some well, some poorly. Definitely don't recommend it. Nothing for kids, and even for adults or young adults. It's something you really got to look into before you decide to make that call. You can't just settle on being a mess and expecting everyone to feel sorry for you, because that just gets old, right? But that notwithstanding, some guys that take it seriously, being girly, drop that train like it's NASCAR, gay, trans, twinkie gay guy, or trans guy, or whatever, they can also be quietly nice, because they're actually doing something, they're working with something, and they're being relaxed and more feminine and vulnerable with you, while your confident masculine strength meets and confirms the same, and then gives way and makes a space and chills out for feminine vulnerability. So if some super skinny gay guy was to do it, you'd be like, eh, not my thing, don't recommend it, but hey, if you're okay at it, fine. It'd be nice to you, dude. You're just really super chilled out, twinkie gay guy, right? You're feminine and vulnerable, right? You may be doing some hair, makeup, wig, stuff, whatever, right? Or if you're trans, right? So, as long as you're not bothering each other, who cares, right? So that's girl work, right? And or if the girlfriend, if the bartender at the bar squeezes your boobs together while taking your drink order, right? That's what I was talking about. You can do that, so I'll give you a tip, be nice to you, how dare you, I dress for me, screw you, pervert, you know, say, well, whatever. You know, you don't, you know, they both deny, you won't explain why, you're embarrassed, argue, lie. That's girl words, right? If they're nice, nice to each other. If they're not nice, probably ignore it, don't do much with them, don't do anything, whatever, don't lose your balls, self-respect, take anyone else's. They'd rather be ignored than be bitchy with a wimp, ultimately, right? And they got better stuff. They'll just switch. They'll switch from that ugly girl, bitchy girl, to, cute girl. Maybe a little, you know, pissy, because I'm, you know, I have my self-pride, you know, but then once we're nice to each other, who cares? We switch to some good girl stuff, right? So that's girl world. Now, what happened is, normal men, regular straight guys, got trapped in girl world, and they all want people looking at them, but they had nothing to look at, right? There was nothing appropriate for their looks, their age, their relationships, the situation. It's just normal dude. Fat, ugly, good looking, old, young, fat, skinny, black, white, doesn't matter. There's nothing appropriate, right? Whereas if a girl is age 3 to 103, or at the very best cases, trans or gay person, but not recommended, no, not for everybody, definitely not for kids. But if you can, you can. And if you fit in, nice, polite, Canadian, who cares, right? The point is that they know what they can do that's appropriate, right? For 3-year-old girl, right? I eat little yogurt, I eat yogurt with little spoon for a little yogurt, I use the big spoon for more yogurt, I'm the cutest girl in the world. Oh, that's so cute. Right? 13-year-old, pretty. Hee hee, hi, mister, I'm pretty. Oh, good, 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 pretty. Stay pretty. No sexy. Stay pretty, pretty, pretty. Stay with it. Nice. Yeah, don't be paranoid. I'm doing paranoid. Yeah, good, good, good stuff, right? And so, and then, you know, 23-year-old, sexy, bartender, whatever. 33, 40, classy. 83, sweet, twinkle in her eye, whatever. There's something appropriate, right? But with guys, normal guys, not gay or trans, whatever, good or bad at it, but just normal guys, there's nothing appropriate for who they are. So it's all the same. That's how everyone turns into the same pretend rude sketchy girlfriend zombie. Right? Hey, put up with me. Yeah, you know it is. It's new to stuff. Right? So it's all the same rude ugly girl. Right? Hey, you know what's supposed to talk about it. Hey, I get away with you. Hey, you're not going to like this, you're not going to like me. Ooh, got it. Hey, ha, ha, ha. It's so stupid. Right? Big secrets acting like rude ugly girls instead of big secrets saving the world and then chilling out around the girls. Right, so we gotta get the guys out of girl world, shove the girls back in, make the guys big secret saving the world, make the girls big secret acting like girls, you know, making everyone, you know, nice to them, you know, you're here to put us in a good mood, make babies. We have to make sure of that. Put us both in a good mood, make babies. Main job, everything else, bonus, pain in the ass, whatever, make money, funny, this, that, smart, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, good bonus. Amy Schumer, why? Oh, fine, whatever. Shopping, boring, but they're usually good mood. Make baby, fine, everything else fine, right? Yeah, they're fine with that, they like that. They say, that's it. Everything else bonus, pain in the ass, yeah, whatever, be happy. So, that's it. So you get the guys out of girl world, shove the girls back in. Girls can make their big secret being good at being girls. Good girl, sweet good girl, bad girl. Ooh, bad girl, look at me, wearing almost nothing, standing there. Ooh, so bad. Bad, you look, god damn it, woman, Jesus Christ, look, is anything near you? Jesus, scary. That's bad girl. Bad guys are a little different. Bad guys can be a little more dangerous. So, point is that the guys are, that's why it's all the same rude ugly girl zombie, or pretend rude ugly girlfriend zombie. Walks around, bothers people, anyone nice, happy, busy, polite, aged, attacks, makes you put up with an act like it, doesn't respect you, you're just impotent, nothing you can say or do. You say, all you can do is act like it, you turn into a zombie, and you run around attacking people. Right? And they like being ignored, acting stupid. Instead of making more, probably want to stop, so ManFoWars.com. Right? Like I said, ManFoWars.com, 100% HD video proof.
Look at me. I'm really okay. Trust me. Everything's gonna be fine. Very strange time in my life. With your feet on the air, no head on the ground. Yeah. You have a collapse, but there's nothing in it. And you'll ask yourself, where is my
You never know what it'll bring. It's the day that you've been waiting on, the day that things change. Yeah, I talk a big game, but back it up like King James when I hear him say. Say.
Everybody fed? Good. Well, welcome to another episode of Canada, Clown Country.
Your balls will thank you.
Gentlemen.
Your balls will thank you.
Talking Fight Club.
Your balls will thank you.
Gentlemen.
Your balls will thank you.
Talking Fight Club. Better than the stress of saying less about less.
Your balls will thank you.